Hello students, today we are going to learn another topic in module 3, that is last class we have seen Freudian theory. Today we are going to study about neo-Freudian theory and trait theory.
So what is neo-Freudian theory? Personality theory is all about.
So we discuss in Freudian theory that we have id, ego and superego. But there are scholars, researchers who claim that that is very basically, biologically on sexuality basis, that is discrimination is done in the theory of Freudian. And Alfred Adler, Harry Stack, Sullivan and Karen Horney developed another model for the personality theory. So there are some neo-Freudians who believe that social relationships are fundamental to the formation and development of personality. So they believed in this, not only the biological development, but also the social relationships. So Alfred Adler says, and he viewed human beings as seeking attain various rational goals in the life, and which he called style of life. So that what the personality behaves according to. So he also placed much emphasis on individuals' efforts to overcome feelings of inferiority. So obviously in human, always he feels try to develop, to overcome the inferiority feelings and to come out of inferiority to reach the superiority feelings. So that Alfred Adler believes. And he says the various rational goals set by the person, and he called it as style of life. And next, coming to Harry Stack Sullivan, so another new Freudian, says that people continuously attempt to establish significant and rewarding relationship with others. So he mentioned one is significant, and also he mentioned that rewarding relationships with others. So that is always attempted by the people. So he was particularly concerned with the individual's effort to reduce tension, such as anxiety, which comes in the personality, or we can say a people or a behavior of the consumer. Next comes the Karen Horney. So, and neo-Freudian was also interested in anxiety. She focused on the impact of child-parent relationship, okay, and the individual's desire to conquer feelings of anxiety. So Horney proposed that individuals be classified into three personality groups: complaint, aggressive and detached. If you see at Karen Horney, so here comes the child-parent relationships and individual desire to conquer feeling of anxiety. And where it comes to Harry Stack Sullivan, so he told again about relationship to reduce the tension, such as anxiety. And coming to the Alfred Adler, so he mentioned various rational goals. So here person, he called it as a style of life and individual efforts to overcome feelings of inferiority. Now these three groups made by the Karen Horney, okay, so those are, one is the complaint individuals. So these are those who move toward others. So they desire to be loved, wanted and appreciated. So these are those who always want people should love them, wanted and appreciated. So people should appreciate them, people should want them, and people should love them. Now come to the second is aggressive individuals, are those who move against others. Okay, so first one was move toward others, and in second, aggressive case, move against others. So they desire to excel and win admiration. So if you see excel and win admiration, they always believe in, they have to take up the chance and they want to admire the people. The next third comes detached individuals. So those who move away from others, again, they away. So in second case it was against, in first case it was towards. So away from others, they desire independence, self-reliance, self-sufficiency and individualism for freedom from obligation. So if you look at your personality, also, you might fall under any one of these type of individual. Okay. So next, let's move to the trait theory. So trait theory. So traits, what are traits? Traits are the features of an individual or tendency of an individual in a particular manner or behavior. Traits helps in defining the behavior
of consumers. According to the trait theorist, an individual personality makeup stems out the trait that he possesses, and identification of traits is important.
So the trait theory represents a departure from the qualitative non-empirical approaches for the Freudian and non-Freudian moments. So trait theory focuses on empirical measures of personality in terms of specific psychological characteristics called traits. So traits are personal characteristics or features that set one person apart from another person. So these are called traits. And trait theorists use personality tests or that pinpoint individual difference in terms of high versus low scores on specific traits. Now moving next. So trait theory, consumers fall in a different set. And the first one is the consumer as innovator and non-innovator. So the degree to which consumers are receptive to new products and new services or new practices. If any product comes in the market which is
very new, so these innovators want to purchase it first and try it first. So the degree we can say. So that is one of the personality. And non-innovators are those who don't want to go for the new products. They want to wait. They want to receive the feedback from everyone. They want to review it. Then they will purchase the product. And next comes the dogmatism. So dogmatism, it's a personality trait that reflects the degree of rigidity a person displays toward the unfamiliar and toward information that is contrary to his or her own established behavior.
So dogmatism is one, you can say, rigidity, okay? For example, a person who is highly dogmatic approach, the unfamiliar, defensive, and with uncertainty and dense culture. In contrast, a person who is less or not dogmatic, readily consider unfamiliar or opposing beliefs.
So here matters about the beliefs, how much the rigidity he is having towards the in his personality. Next comes the social character. So ranges on a continuum for inner directedness to other directedness. So inner directedness, we can say rely on own values when evaluating the products. And next comes the innovators. So and other directedness look to others, less likely to be innovators. So first in inner directedness, these type of personality adopt the new product immediately. They don't look for others and they rely on their own values for checking the products or evaluating the product. But other directedness, they look for others, what they are doing, then they will go for purchases. So moving further, that is need for uniqueness. So consumer who avoid appearing to conform to expectation or standards of others. So many consumers acquire and display material possessions because they want to be differentiated from other people. So that is uniqueness, the personality required. The wear, the apparel they wear, the shoes, you can say belt or specs, something using all the mobile phones, they want to be a unique from others. So consumer need for uniqueness is defined as an individual pursuit of differentness related to others that is achieved through the acquisition of consumer goods in order to enhance one's personal and social identity. So ultimately the consumer believe in uniqueness. So he wanted to be unique from the other. He want to look another person from the people who are surrounding to them. So next comes optimum. Before going to that, we have this expert sample items from consumer need for uniqueness cell. I collect unusual products as a way of telling people I am different. Okay. So you know this. I collect unusual products as a way of telling people I am different. You can say the way, the type of dress I'm having, the collection I'm having. So when dressing, I have sometimes dared to be different in a way that others are likely to disapprove. So you have observed this, you might have felt this. This happens in your classrooms also, that some people always want to look different, uniqueness. So when products or brands I like become extremely popular, I lose interest in them. So if you see the earlier, very rare people used to have in mobile phones. Now everyone is having mobile phone. In again mobile phone, they should go for a beyond very costly mobile, which people are not having. Next, as far as I am concerned, when it comes to the products I buy and the situations in which I use them, custom and rule are made to be broken. So that is another situation. Fifth one, I have sometimes purchased unusual products or brands as a way to create more distinctive personal image. So always the type of personality wants to look different. Now coming to the optimum stimulation level, it is a personality trait that measures the level or amount of novelty or complexity that individuals seek in their personal experiences. Okay. So novelty, you know, variety they seek, complexity that individuals seek in their personal experience. So high optimum stimulation level, consumers tend to accept risky and novel product more readily than low OSL consumers. So these type of people adopt the high risky products or we can say goods, so that they will adopt it very fast. Next comes the variety novelty seeking. So which measures consumers' degree of variety seeking. So example include exploratory purchase behavior, use innovativeness and vicarious exploration. So they always look for new thing, variety of goods or products they always looking for. So this was the trade theory.